Pumpkin Firecracker.
Good boy. Whoa. Good job, Pumpkin. Happy birthday, Pumpkin.
Welcome back, Mangler3M here. We're going to continue with the White Mage questing that we had this morning. I think the game's already up. I'll flip over to that. There we go. Alright, White Mage, I call it. It's really Conjurer. You start with Conjurer, but we had not gotten here while we were allowed to switch until just now, and we just switched. So I'm a brand new White Mage. I think that means level 1. Why does it say it's something random I need to do? Wind up airship. Oh, I have a minion. Used. I can now summon the wind up airship minion. Now, can I do that? Is that an action? Is that an inventory? You can now summon. They said something about a whistle, but I don't see. Would it be the character thing? Actions? I don't see a whistle here. General. Jump. Target forward. Prepare. Return. Minion guy? Is that where? Despite it being the first and most ambitious undertaking of my Highwood Skyways founder, Tatanora, the Invincible actually never took flight. Its 10-year construction period plagued by accidents, material shortages, sabotage, and outright incompetence. Summon it. Oh, I have to put it on. It actually worked. My first minion. A wind-up airship. Is it going to follow me? It is. Does it fight? I don't know. Emote. Mark. Focus target. What is focus target? Too far away. My first king. Brother Isumiyan wishes to assign you your first task as a conjurer of Still Glade Fiend. The part of conjurer becomes you, Mangler. Without further ado, I shall assign you your first task as a conjurer of Still Glade Fiend. Just beyond the city gates, you will encounter squirrels, ladybugs, and funglars. Fungoid funguses. I would have you slay 3 of each. Lest you wonder how I can so coolly order the taking of life, know that things are not as they were once were, as a consequence of the calamity, and I may add, through no fault of their own, these creatures have become a burden to the Twelves Wood. A burden it cannot well bear. As a conjurer, it is your duty to carry out the will of the Forest. By employing your powers in so doing, you will come to learn something of your art. Go now, Mangler, and perform your first task in the name of your gods. Oh, it's focusing it on that. Okay. Dismiss. Okay, so they need me to go out into the wild blue yonder. I have no idea how my plan is going to go. Conjurer's Guild has called to see. Okay, that's the level 15 quest. I'm not interested in that right now. Botanist Guild. Is it you? Is it this? Another tune. Okay.
Thank you.
because I think rogues are impossible to see. Okay, we return.
Thank you.
following me as my team. Seek here no one, and seek no more, if you have found him. What can I do for you, friend? So Brother Yi Sumiyan bid you to come to me to learn about the element of Earth. That is well, the power of Earth is the solid foundation upon which a conjurer stands. I could have been lecturing you for days of its intricate variation and properties, but I rather suspect the busy life of the adventurer would not afford the time required for such extended discourse. Accordingly, I shall offer you an opportunity to experience the qualities of Earth firsthand, in common. Now mark me well, and you will be exactly what east of here, to the grounds of trace being stables, there exists a patch of soil that bears the mark of corruption, see here. When you found that place, reach out to the focus of the Earth's problem and attempt to commune with it, as it can cause you to change. Resentful of your intrusion, a tainted being of the sensing upon the earth shall appear upon the powers of conjuring strike down upon the land which helps to me. Much of the nature of earth will be limited to during the struggle. I trust you will return to your eyes. First disaster coming up.
Thank you.
Whisper of your accomplishments. How did it feel to confront the embodiment of Earth, to endure its onslaught? Has the crushing power of its element shaken the very marrow of your bones? Corruption occurs when the land's wounds are prevented from healing. In vanquishing the tainted sprite, you permit the Earth's energies to flow unimpeded and to nourish the land once more. Can you not sense the strength of the earth returning? Already the land begins to heal. Thanks to your actions, that field will once again bear bountiful crops. When next you have reason to call upon your art, look back upon this task and that which you accomplished. Experience once more the grinding weight of the earth's fury, and revel in the memory of life flowing anew through the land you helped restore. With such thoughts, shall your understanding of nature continue to grow. I hope you are paying attention, Sophie. See this adventurer here? Mangler came all the way from Still Lake Vane just to hear my lesson. You do well to solidify his example. If you wish to become a conjurer worthy of that name, you must make an effort to study nature. Do you attend me, young lady? Why should I bother studying nature? I can conjure already. You have a rare gift for healing, Sophie. A wonderful gift. Yet there is more to being a conjurer than... I don't want to do more. I want to heal. I'm good at healing. You can't make me do those other things. Sometimes I wonder why I even try. Sophie joined the guild shortly before you came to us. As you yourself just experienced, she possesses a prodigious talent for healing. Indeed, despite her tender years, I know of few conjurers who are her equal in that field. Alas, nature, the very wellspring of her power, holds no interest for the child, and when she should by rights be learning about the land, she prefers instead to wander it, healing people on earth. You, in contrast, have been a most attentive student. I have taught you all I know about the element of Earth. You may report back to Brother Isumi and tell him as much. turn, but tell me, how did you fare under Nolan's expert tutelage? When you delved deep into the earth and felt its suffocating weight, its life sustaining vigor, such experiences will serve you well. And have you aught else to report? A fledgling conjurer and selfie cast healing magic upon you? Let's confess of sharing Nolan's frustration with the law. As you yourself have witnessed, Sylphie possesses a natural talent in the conjury of mending and restoration. Alas, her gifts appear in the blinding her in the first study, and she outright refuses to learn about the natural one. She knows that the holy elements of earth and moon is quite incapable of finding even the tiniest pebble in the faintest breeze. I have tried upon numerous occasions to explain to her that conjurers who are ignorant of the source of their power pose a risk to themselves and others, but all to no avail. Should she continue to deny the debt she owes to nature and indulge in ever more reckless displays of power, there is ever free responsibility that she will create a dangerous imbalance. Needless to say, I am presently at a loss to know how such an inevitable eventuality. Occurs to me, Mangler. It may be that your encounter with Sylphie was ordained by the elementals. Should you chance to meet with her again, I ask that you strive to impress upon her the importance of opening oneself to nature's voice. Mayhap she will listen to me. But we've discussed our wayward uniform's education enough. Let us speak instead of one of the more learned pupils, namely you. The progress you have made does your great credit. You great credit, Mangler. Though you are yet new to the art of conjury, you are no stranger to nature's embrace. Considering all you have learned, I hope you understand the true significance of these words. Alright, you give me a robe, or a hat, or a ring, or bracelets. Let's go with the rope because it helps you win. Learned repose. Now we can cast sleep on it. For your work spells. Upgrade.
Or maybe not.
could run. Wow. Sad. Try sharing the joy of a near heart with her. That'll clear my mind so much. Emotion to refer to Anna. You're odd. Right. she's starting to like you. Okay. Now that you've broken the ice, I bet if you surprise her and start dancing, she'll laugh at you.
Yes.
shadows, and sylphs often visit in the dead of night, along with the rest of the season of the dead. They help give an objection to the presence, and they seem grateful for their congregation. So much so, in fact, that last night they left us a token of appreciation in the form of instruments and a lot of giant instruments. Their generosity is more than welcome, of course, but the sheer quantity of things make gathering them almost something of a chore. And it's not as if I don't have enough to do already. In short, I'd be most grateful for any help you could give. About? Doom Assign says he needs his break, the mirror of that sniveling crying for relief at a time like this. Has he already forgotten how short-handed we are since that business with the hell's long the other day? And sending an unknown venturer to do his bleep in the mountains. That self-serving side thinks only of his own woes, working his sore souls while welcoming all manner of field-grabbing adventures to our community. Useless. Makes my blood boil, it does. It's not you I should be giving a piece of my mind to. You seem a decent of sort, considering. Still, I understand this is due to keeping our little stranger passage in these parts. Anyway, I appreciate you being able to support me. Mindful of this. Go on, you understand. Mm-hmm. So, targets, Parsimon Trent is willing to permit an adventurer to assist him in fulfilling an order from the Lancer's Guild. Lost, are we? Unsure how to navigate the Rosewood and Ebony stalls? Very well, if you wish to know more about the markets, I'll give you a practical education for free. As master of the markets, I entertain many requests. This order from the Whalers, for example, would I delegate their fulfillment to my hirelings, that I might attend to such tasks as I am capable of performing. For your personal betterment, I shall delegate the fulfillment of this particular request to you. I bid you search the stalls for the bone spearhead, a pot of beeswax oil, and a length of bramble wood rope, and deliver them to Trangild and Lancer's Guild. There is much more to be found in the stalls. I have dedication to seek it in the coin of the period. However, as my representative, you need only offer my honest payment. None will deny me. In fact, many will be all too eager to part with their owners. So numerous are the debts I owe. A fine proposition, isn't it? I have spared a simple task and a plebeian prince's mercantile expense. I should rightly charge you for such an opportunity. Don't worry now, I'm a man of my word and terms will stay. Deliver the goods to King Gil to assume the fit of the world. Discerning eyes. Parsimon Trent. I never hear that name again, maybe too soon. Think you're going to make money? Take this. Aha! Same person, honor and privilege to serve you. What business do you have with me, adventurer? You come upon a bidding from Master Parsimon Trent. So soon, I'm impressed. I placed my order only a short time ago. Yet here are all the items I requested. Truly masters every bit as resourceful as I say. Really fortunate to work on such a man. He would do well to move himself in his image. Do you have any aspirations as a merchant? Alright, Lancer stuffs squirrels with squirrels. Hey, let's go out. We need to fight something. Squirrel problem. Fresh faced adventure. Very manner of person I wish to meet. Looking for someone to track down and get a foul or a dozen of them. Gnawing on support pillars. It's my delight. Not here, perhaps. Central Shroud. Large squirrels. I can do that. Thank you. that. What's that? You wonder what happens to adventurers who fail to complete such trifling tasks? Why, such sluggards soon find there's no place for them in the city. And where they do end up living after living in Dominia? Well, you shall hear the truth of that before long. To deliver a sealed message to the markets. Find Shaded Gower. That's perfect. From Flibos. go. Let's see. She wants to know about the available stock of potions at the market. Hardly a matter that warrants a letter, much less a hiring of a courier. Why could she ask me that in person? Adventures, well-being, her demons, some difficult things. Truly, so without a warrant. The team pressed outsiders, it's only because so many of them have brought chaos into the forefront, and such sins have, as theirs have not soon forgotten. Yet, I suppose we might endure to be a little less cold. Okay. So we did a bunch of little quests. Got basically experience. Let's see if I can get over that. Oh, okay. You all type bigger shit. State and cheer that waned. I make no secret about my disinclination towards Gridanians, as you may know, but I just saw a rare sight that I would be remiss to share with the full adventure. Just over yonder in the acorn orchard, I saw a comely maiden, new to these benign parts, and wager dancing with a gaggle of moonlights. It was a dance I'd never seen before, I've seen my fair share. Do they perhaps ready themselves for some fresh break? After so much doom and gloom, I shouldn't mind a day very much. Just the thought excites me. Did you see what that's about? Alright, ignore the animals. So this isn't far in just my own defense of the experience. It's all the more surprising considering they obeyed the timber master without demur. What I wouldn't give to know his secrets. But I must wait here for the unruly charges for my unruly charges. I wonder though, might you ask the man how the timber lived? So I can actually go right in here. Oh, I wish I could. I have to go over here. Seems able enough, but no generosity for herself, none for her, she has none for her charges. Give the young ones these on her behalf, bid them return to their website.
Thank you.
Right, would you agree? And then you can write it. If you need a double 10, you can write it. Alright, we're gonna stop when we get somewhere where the guys are about living mauling. If so, if you do a white mage, so thank you. see where it goes. Yes. Later, have a great weekend. I'll see you guys next time.